Yo, what up, it's Don.
Sammy Lee here.
We are the Soul Brothers. Good to see you, Soul Squad. You know, we're back up in it. We're going to do some cushion. This is a cushion talk.
Yep.
Is this hashtag cushion talk or what?
Cushion talk, is that what we're going to call it? All right. You know, so, someone asked us to compare these three. God, I'm sorry. I should write down your username and stuff, but I forget. And even if I do... Then it's on my phone right now, but then I don't know where it is, so I'm sorry.
Yeah, it's too deep in there.
Yeah, there's a lot of comments and stuff, so whenever I see a comment or a repeating comment of like you guys asking to do something, I try to help you guys out. So here's a video comparing like Nike cushions.
Yeah, Air Max, of course, is one of the oldest.
Mm-hmm.
Zoom would be second oldest.
And then
in the ones we're talking about, and then you have Lunar Long, which is fairly new as far as tech, as far as cushion tech for Nike. A lot newer than Zoom.
Yeah.
Zoom is old. It's like 20 years old.
Zoom
is old.
Yeah,
like 20 years old.
Mm-hmm.
But okay, so how should we start this?
So let's start off with Lunar Long. So I just got this Nike Lunar Epic. I think that's what it's called, Flyknit or whatever. And this is straight up Lunar Long, and it feels really, really nice. Super plush, really soft on the foot. Impact protection is great. And if you guys can see these lines, they compress. And I think that helps with impact protection also. But let's just go over this. We went on the website. Actually, Nike's website, and says right here, it says since 2008, I believe that's when Lunar Long was made. It said it's inspired by the way astronauts bounce on the moon. So Lunar Long cushioning is 30% lighter than standard Phylon foam, yet responsive, and also it distributes the impact better than regular Phylon foam. So that's what it says. How does it work? Lunar Long works by distributing impact evenly across the foot. So instead of pressure hitting just like the toe area or just the heel, it distributes all of that force within the foam, and you have better impact protection that way.
Are you guys taking notes or what? You guys got a bit, this is gonna be a pop quiz after this.
Exactly. The first basketball shoes to introduce Lunar Long was the Nike Hyperdunk 2012,
yes,
I believe.
I think that's the first.
Yeah, I think that's the first.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe even the...
No, 2008. Oh, 2008. Lunar Long in it.
Oh, 2008.
Yeah.
Oh, not 2012?
No.
Oh, okay. All right.
The 08 had Lunar Long in it.
Okay. And, so there's actually two kinds of Lunar Long. There's just the free, just the whole midsole is Lunar Long. And then there's basically like the whole midsole is Lunar Long also. But then it's basically caged because it's inside. It's a drop-in midsole.
Yeah.
So, this setup is not as nice.
No.
Especially for basketball. I miss the Nike Hyperdunk 2012, I believe. The one where it's this one. This one. I think that's 2012.
Yes, 2012. Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, so I miss that one. I wish they would bring that back. But, let's just rate these as in like... impact protection 0 to 10.
Okay,
so what would you rate it?
Which one?
Just Lunar Long in general.
Just Lunar Long in general? Well, it's tricky because it's a lot of it has to do with how it's implemented.
Exactly.
Picturing it was implemented uncaged, right?
Mm-hmm.
And free, free range. We like our cushions free range a lot of times. Organic,
GMO
USDA.
Free.
You feel me?
Yep.
Just a free, like, for example, this. I have the Lunar TR1. Okay, this is just, there's no drop in midsole. The midsole is out and you can feel it. It's Lunar Long. And this is like, I would say an 8.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? It's really, really nice. It's really dope. It's not like crazy bouncy, but there is impact protection.
Yeah, it's not really bouncy that much.
No.
It's more of just like a subtle, you just kind of like feel it, like a sponge, kind of. So I think that's what it is. It's more of a responsive cushion that they're trying to go for instead of like a bounce.
Yeah.
So yeah, if you like that kind of cushion, then yeah, Lunar Long is for you. So
the problem with it, like here in the drop-in midsole, is it just for some reason it starts to feel really mushy,
and it bottoms out really quickly.
Yeah. And it doesn't disperse the force as much, right? Because it's locked in there. And you know, I don't know. It just is a little firmer.
Yeah.
You know, and then it gets kind of compressed, and it's not great.
Okay. Now moving on to Air Max. So I don't like Air Max personally. So this is the only Air Max shoe that I have, or shoe that has Max Air Max cushioning. So it says here Max Air. It's lightweight, so it instead of having to use foam, it's basically air. So you see all this space that's just air.
Yeah.
There doesn't have to have foam right here. You see, so it's air is replacing where the foam is supposed to be.
Right.
So it's making it more lightweight.
But there's still, it's not totally replaced because there's these towers in there.
Exactly.
These shocks, right? Because if it was just air, it'd be way too.
Yeah, exactly.
It'd be way too much.
Yeah. But. So those towers are for support. But let's see, it says it absorbs impact when the foot strikes the ground, protecting muscles, joints, and tendons, and it returns to the original shape. It's supposed to be super durable.
This shit is old.
Yeah, it's old.
It's just old and outdated. It doesn't do a lot. It looks really cool, you know, but I don't know. It doesn't do a whole lot. I don't like the feel. You know, I had the Audacities.
They felt pretty nice.
Those are dope. It was nice, but it's not on par, dog. Too much.
Well, I have the LeBron anymore. 12 lows, which have Nike Air Max.
Yeah,
but they're in the box. Do you guys want to see it?
No. No, fuck all
okay,
that.
Okay, whatever.
But then there's the you know, the Air Max.
Yeah.
Right, the real Air Max, you know.
The Flyknit Runner thing?
Yeah. Those are like, that's like a full length setup. Yeah, so real gnarly.
Bubbly. Yeah, the one thing I don't like about it, it just raises you way too high from the ground. You don't really have a lot of corked feel. Response, I guess, is good because it doesn't really like compress that much, and impact protection is good too. But other than that, for basketball, I don't think it's the best type of cushion, and I think Nike should just remove it from basketball, you know. So there you go. And then last but not least is the Zoom Air. In Korean there's no Z sound, so we say Zoom. So this is Nike Zoom right here. And this is full length. This is the Soda Sexy Time of my Hyperdunks over there. Also, cord feel is actually good because they thin out the Phylon right above it. And it depends on if it's like top loaded or bottom loaded. It feels differently. But this is the bounciest cushion that Nike has. And I think one of the bounciest cushions that there is.
I think it's the bounciest cushion there ever was.
Yep, and there ever was.
Yeah.
You know? Impact protection is good.
Yeah.
I think it's actually phenomenal.
Yeah.
Response is not very good though.
Yeah, it's not the best. If you want response, you don't really go to a Zoom setup.
Unless it's like either bottom loaded or encased in something or caged.
Yeah. Or if it's like the Kobe 11, right? You have you have a Zoom unit in the heel, but in the forefoot where you want your response, it's very thin and there's no Zoom. You know, you just have Lunar Lawn. So that's a cool setup if you want response. But
So responsiveness, it's not very good because, you know, you feel your foot going inside the Zoom unit, you know, and then popping back up, and that wastes a few milliseconds, or it just feels like you're a little slower, which can make a difference while you're performing, you know?
Yeah, the actual amount of time we're talking about is so minute, but the overall feeling of being light on your feet, there is something to be said for that.
Exactly.
And, you know, sometimes, like, I'll put on a shoe that's super responsive, and I just, my legs feel fresh, and I just feel super explosive, and I might play differently that day. I might play better. I might be faster, you know? And it's, even if it's a placebo effect, it helps.
So, out of all three of these, we're not going to say which one's the best, because that doesn't make sense. It's all targeted toward a specific need for a specific type of athlete, whether it is you need impact protection, you need a response, you know, you want court feel or whatever it is. We just kind of wanted to explain to you guys which setups with the cushions are like the best for which type of player you are, what you want, you know?
Yeah, so, I mean, these are the technologies, and Nike implements them in a lot of different ways. for instance, you know, like in the Kobe 11, they're mixing Zoom and Lunar Lawn together in the same cushion. I'm not sure if there's any Air Max and Lunar Lawn or Air Max and Zoom. There is in the LeBrons, there's Zoom units in there and Air Max.
Yeah, in the heel.
Yeah, in the heel. So
I think.
So they mix it up. So, you know, if you kind of want to know about what each cushion does, there it is.
Yeah.
And then you can kind of pick what setup you like. Now, we might want to say a few of our favorites.
Yep.
Just so they know. So one of my favorites of all time is the LeBron 11 drop-in midsole. And it's the same as this, but it's a little taller, right? So if you were to stick it in a Kobe 9, which I do, it brings you up just a little bit.
You do?
I do.
You do.
I do. So it's the same as this, except right here is a nice Zoom unit. Full
so
length.
So the sexy time.
And that shit is fucking bouncy.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's too much and I don't play in it, but you know, that's one of my favorite setups for sure. Mm-hmm.
But yeah, that's it. That's comparing those three. Thank you guys for watching. Hope we helped you guys out, and we'll see you guys in the next video.